I'm really honored to be here today and try to explain a little bit what we do from my government to promote our country brand and also to help our companies to internationalize. So sorry for this complicated and title, but I try to explain what we do. And my presentation is going to be about this fact, no? How we countries compete in the world to try to sell our products, our services, attract talent to our countries, investment, which in the end depends a lot on the image that your country has. So as you can imagine, when we talk about a country image, there is a lot of different factors that come into mind to the consumer and to the trade people. I have to highlight that most of the job that we do from our bodies within the administration, our embassies, target the trade. We don't really have the money to target the consumers. So sometimes we are very successful in one sector, letting know all the businessmen involved in that sector that we are very good. And therefore, our companies benefit from the fact that they come from, for instance, Spain or Italy, or as we will see during the presentation. But it's a fact that many trade people, when they have to choose a product, they take into account the origin of this service or product. For instance, if you were in the position to buy a computer out of a manufacturer from the United States or Europe or China, for the same price, the same service, most likely you will go for an American computer, even though it's manufactured in China, no? But I'm talking about the brand. So you will go most likely for an Apple or an HP than from a brand that comes from a country that you trust less. So in the end, the country brand is something that helps your companies to compete around the world. So when you take advantage of this, of a good country image or country brand, your companies really can sell more and a better price than when you don't, you lack this kind of country image. So that's why almost every country in the world is trying to create this country image, and from that we try to help our companies to get distribution in foreign markets and also to win projects when they bid for big projects in the infrastructure, energy, and this kind of sectors. And I would like to start, for instance, asking you some questions when we talk with some countries. We're going to see that creating the country image or country brand has some items that are very easy to do. For instance, creating a logo is something that you can do in just an office with two people designing that brand. But that doesn't make your brand valuable to the trade and the consumers, no? This is something that you create. We will see many logos in a minute. But that doesn't mean that you have you add value to your companies, to your products. There are much more within the country brand. And well, you see that there is a scale over there. And in the end, what gets you advantage is creating the competitive advantage, the competitive identity. No? For instance, if we talk about cars, everybody will think about Japan, the United States, Germany, as countries where you can really rely or trust when you buy a car. No? However, for instance, maybe you are not aware, and that's my job, and I'm going to take this opportunity to tell you that Spain is the second manufacturer of cars in Europe. We manufacture more cars than Italy, than France, the UK. The number one is Germany, we are the second country in Europe. And that means something. If we can convey this, this message to the traders, to the consumers, that means that a country that manufactures cars is a developed country. No? But for you, and I will show you some results from some studies, we always find that you think about Spain as a more traditional, less developed country. No? I will try to prove you wrong with all the data that I'm going to provide you. So in the end, we are all trying to compete in a world where everybody wants to sell and advance its industries, its products, and sometimes the country image is a differential factor. We in Spain, we use a lot now the European brand. In case of doubt, we position ourselves as Europeans. And I think in your mind, correct me if I'm wrong, but I mean, Americans, Europeans, Japanese, Koreans, I mean, we are kind of the group of countries that you think, or you tend to think, that we are industrialized countries and we produce reliable, high quality products. One measure that sometimes people think there is a relation, no, between a country brand, a country image, is the size of the country and the image, no, that you have. However, this is not always the case. As you can see here, for instance, the economy of Spain will be pretty much the size of the economy of Texas. The economy of California will be pretty much the size of France. No? So in these cases, you can maybe think that, well, there is a relation, no, between the image and the size. But in some other cases, China, India, Russia, that's not the case. I mean, I don't think you will buy a Russian car before a European, German, Spanish car, because you trust much more the Russian country brand. No? So there is not always a relation. However, there is an example of a small country like Switzerland, which a great country image, and it's a really small country. No? So there is no relation, or not always a relation between the country. There is an index, which is the global presence, which factors economic, political, and social effective projection outside your borders, which predicts more the country image and there's a relation, no, between those two factors. And as you see, the United States is on top of this ranking. Eh? But Spain is not too bad. I mean, we're at least in this ranking, no? And if we talk about the US and its brands, let me just do a quick exercise. Which animal do you think would be related to the US? I mean, if you talk to the, because it's part of the country image, no? What comes to your mind when you talk about adjectives, nouns, brands, animals, food? There are many, many factors, no, that come to your mind when you talk about a country brand. If you have to talk about, if we talk about the US, which animal do you think would highlight as the most prominent as the image, no, of the US? Anybody? A horse, okay. What? I don't even know. Eagle. People say eagle. That's true. Eh? When we ask some people in my office, people said eagle. Well, I would say bison would be much more in Europe. No, at least the idea that we have of an animal coming from the U.S. If we say a gnome, which gnome? Tell me something about a food, a sport that comes to your mind when you talk about the U.S. Football is one. Baseball. Hamburgers. Eh? Weapons. What about adjectives? What about adjectives? Any adjective that we can stick to the U.S.? Freedom. Superpower. Pride. What about brands? Well, you have so many that Coca-Cola, Apple, Google. I mean, that's why you are so well positioned when we talk about your country image. If we go to, well, I just collected some brands here. For sure, there are many more, no? But that's what, at least to my mind, came when I thought about American brands, no? If we go to Italy, tell me an animal. Anybody? I didn't find any, but I mean. What about a noun? Food? Pizza? Pasta? Fashion? Adjective? Romance? Friendly? What about brands? Ferrari, Lamborghini, no? Versace, Gucci, so fashion cars. Well, I found that those ones that you can see here. If we go to China, what about an animal? Panda. That's the panda bear. What about unknown? Unknown. Spring rolls? Dogs? Because they eat dogs. Adjectives? Red? Communism, maybe? What about brands? Okay, more? Huawei, telephones, Bank of China, Lenovo. Well, there are a few. Now it comes the good one. What about Spain? Tell me what you know about Spain. Animal. A bull. Good. Always the bull. Eh? You know that Baldomero and I, by law, when we go outside our country, we are bullfighters. We cook a paella, and we know how to dance flamenco. Eh? That's something that everybody thinks you do, because you are from Spain, I mean. Hmm? What about nouns, foods?
Wine.
Famous dish? Paella, gazpacho, sangria, tortilla de patatas. What about adjectives? This is something that we use in our campaigns. What adjectives for the Spanish? Passion. Passion for life was our campaign, our tourist campaign. Everything under the sun. Mm-hmm. These are adjectives that we have used to promote our country. Spanish brands. Any? Come on. No one? Zara? Fashion? Zara? Nobody? The biggest retailer, H&M and Zara. But nobody knows that Zara comes from Spain. Why? Because they don't really think Spain adds any value to their strategy. So it's a well, it's a pity for us, no? Because we don't have so many international brands, and when you have, they don't really show them the pride of being from Spain. Real Madrid, Airbus. Okay, you didn't know that Airbus was a brand from Spain. 10% of the 380, A400, 350 is built in Spain. 20 in UK, 20 in France, 20 in Germany. Italy is not there. We are part of the consortium, building the best airplane with Boeing, no? The two biggest countries that build planes. No? SEAT, which is our national car brand, belongs to Volkswagen, but for instance, we manufacture the Audi 5 in Spain. Nobody knows, but if you buy an Audi 5, most likely will be from our factories in Spain. Banco de Santander, well, as you see here, of course, the Flamenco and the Toro, these are some of our brands, no? But my job is to convey this image. Spain has the longest network of high-speed rail in Europe, second to China only, and China is a huge continent. So we have more miles than Germany, Italy, the UK. If you go to Spain, you will have a high-speed rail station less than 30 miles from any 50,000 city inhabitants where you can connect to the network. So compared to the United States, you haven't started yet with this technology. Imagine going to Las Vegas in 2 hours, 2 hours, 15 minutes. No? That's the kind of infrastructure that we have. And most likely, unless you have visited Spain recently, you didn't know that. No? We get 82 million tourists, second only to France. But we get income from the tourists. We are the second country in the world, only second to the US. So we are a really tourist country, so we need the infrastructure, airport, high-speed rails, highways. We are the country in Europe with more miles of highways also. So state-of-the-art infrastructure, state-of-the-art companies building infrastructures around the world. For instance, you know the new Panama Channel was built by a Spanish company. The new high-speed rail Meca Medina has been finalized and has been built by Spanish companies. We are building the big tunnel in Seattle. We are building out of the 2-3 tranches of the high-speed rail in Los Angeles, San Francisco, are being built by Spanish companies. We just won last week the People Mover, $2 billion project in Los Angeles Airport International, and many, many, many another infrastructure, because Spain is huge in infrastructure. We are out of the six countries in the world that can build a plane. We are one of those countries completely. And we are very strong in renewables. Maybe you know that the second operator of wind parks in the US is Iberdrola Renovables, which is a Spanish company with headquarters in Portland. So my job is to try to convey this image that we are strong in infrastructure, strong in cars, strong in high rail speed, strong in renewables, strong in satellites, technology in general. This study is funny because it shows the best known brand in every country. And even though Italy is the most famous with France country regarding fashion, you can see here that the only fashion brand that appears in this map is Zara in Spain. No? And well, you can see in the other countries which is more famous. Well, what I was telling before, every country in general is fighting for the big world market pie, and everybody's promoting an image, no? So building, so creating the image, the logo is the easy part, no? The difficult is attaching to this logo a real value, no? And that the people in the market you wanna conquer, really can attach different meanings to this logo, no? For instance, can you raise your hand who has seen before this logo? Okay, so have you been in Spain, the ones that... well, this is Amiro, the painter. We have the right to use this logo for only for tourist purposes, not for commercial purposes, because I think it's a great logo. And, well, maybe because of the logo, we get 82 million people. And, well, the thing is that I'm going now to the US, not to your country. We don't have a really strong image. We know that. We are little by little getting some advantages thanks to the companies that are winning projects or setting up shops or because in the end it's the companies help you a lot. You can do many, many things, hotel, many, many, run many, many advertisement campaigns, PR campaigns, but if you don't have the companies behind, usually don't really get too much, no, out of this money that you invest, no? However, we were here before you. You know that Utah was part of Spain, no? I hope. Do you know that? Escalante. El Padre Escalante, no? Okay. So this was a part of the Louisiana Purchase, and it was Spain for 40 years or something, no? Till the French get it back, and then they sold it to the America, to the US, no? Again, in 1803, no? Or something like that. Not very many people know the history of Spain, but we have been part of your country for many years. And, well, sometimes we are sad because we learned about the black legend, no? About the Spanish conquer. But I mean, I think at least we Spanish, we think we did many, many, many things right. Of course, at that time, with the culture of that time, which we did some things that were not right with the culture of today, no? But I mean, we brought many, many things, no? El caballo, for instance, we brought el caballo to the US, no? Well, if we go to, well, this is about the tourists, eh? But this is an angle hexagon that in the end allows you to compare many, many countries. But I just have made the effort to talk about Spain, no? Because this was my opportunity. Eh? And well, we run a study by Instituto Elcano, and that's what it says. In the end, 60% of Americans think we are traditional, 32% of Americans think we are poor, 27% of Americans think we have something to do with agriculture, which is true. But it's like California, no? California has to do something with agriculture, but it's only 2% of the GDP. In Spain, it's 2.5. I mean, our GDP, agricultural GDP, is very, very small. We are an industrialized country. And our best policy is to take people to Spain, not only tourist people, but trade people, no? Because when people get to Spain, and I don't know, how many have been in Spain in the last 10 years? You are losing. One of the best countries in the world. I mean, you have to be there. Go there, travel there. You're going to see a very rich country, a lot of culture, a lot of modernism, and it's a very nice country. Eh? So, I mean, there are many countries around the world, but I mean, we have a little bit of everything, no? Not only beaches. And, well, what we have seen is that little by little our image is improving. Eh? And interestingly, Toro, El Toro is there always when we ask the Americans about Spain. Flamenco, it doesn't appear in the study that we run. Maybe because it's included in culture. Yeah? Gastronomy and football comes to the mind of the Americans. And magnificent country. So, well, people maybe don't know too much, but I mean, they consider a magnificent country, Spain. Yeah? And paella, party, beach, and crisis. We had a big crisis in 2007. Surprisingly, they don't come to the mind of the Americans. Well, part of the image comes from your sport people. You know that we are, maybe you know that we are silver medals in the Olympics, only after the Americans, because you always beat us. But I mean, we have been three times silver medals, and with local Spanish people. Soccer world champions, I think you know Nadal, no? I don't know the golfers, Severiano, these people, Real Madrid. If we go to the movies, anybody knows these people? Anybody knows a name? Spain are very famous because they are in Hollywood. But maybe here, nobody knows, no? Most likely. Well, they are Bardem and Penelope Cruz. They are Antonio Banderas, the director Almodóvar, who won an Oscar. Very famous in Spain, but I see nobody knows them here. What about singers? Julio Iglesias, Enrique Iglesias, Plácido Domingo, Bisbal. Nobody knows Plácido Domingo, the singer? Yeah, okay, there's somebody that knows. Okay, somebody famous, opera singer. Most likely the most famous with Carreras and Pavarotti, no? Okay, another factor very important, your companies. What are they doing in your market? We are underrepresented in the American market. According to our situation in GDP in the world, we are now the 14th by GDP. We were the 8th some years ago. We are getting backward because the Chinese, the Indians, all those big countries are surpassing because they are much more many people, no? So we are going down in the ranking. But why we are underrepresented? Because our natural market is Latin America. We are the second investor in Latin America. So that's something to take into account. If you go to Latin America, all the water, banks, electric, telephone companies are run by Spanish companies. Only the United States invests more in Latin America than us. We are very well positioned regarding the people that go to study in Spain. No? So many, many people choose Spain after Reino Unido and Italy. We are third in the ranking. However, we don't send too many Spanish people. And regarding investment, we are in the position that pretty much is like our GDP position. Well, this is a quick map of our companies where we are, and we are seeing that we are moving more and more west. We hope that we are going to see more Spanish companies in Utah soon, hopefully. And just to summarize, and before just finishing with a little bit of what we do, just remember that we don't have a very differentiated image in the U.S. Part of the reason is that the Italians, they have, how many Italian families are in this country? How many German families are come in the U.S. from this family? We didn't come to this country. We left when we sold the Utah and California territories, and we concentrated our immigration to Latin America, no? So that's part of the reason. So, and that helps you a lot to create your image. No? Italy, part of the strength of Italy in the US is how many Italian families live here, or German families for the Germans. No? Okay, and this is a video. I hope I can run the video. No, the video, can I run the video now? This is how we present ourselves. Well, and just to end my presentation, we are organizing 6 offices within the embassy, and we run many trade shows. We come to all the cybersecurity, wind power, you name it. That's our job, is to bring the companies to exhibit in whatever the show it is, Las Vegas, Chicago, LA, San Francisco. We organize sometimes big events. And I don't want to take too much time from you, but I mean, we have a lot of instruments within our organization, which is the Spanish Institute for Foreign Trade, regarding the promoting exports, the Instituto Cervantes, which is our body within the administration to promote the culture, and Tour España, which is the body to attract tourists to Spain. We are connected through Marca España, and we run many, many programs to generate business in Spain for the Spanish companies. And that's it. I'm now open to answer any questions that you might have. Thank you so much. You mean with the population, what?
Yeah, with your population.
Well, it's shrinking. I don't think it's shrinking anymore, no? We during the crisis, a lot of immigrants went back home, no? And the natality in Spain is very low, that's true. But, I mean, we have great universities, great engineers, a lot of creativity. We are kind of the Florida or California of Europe, no? I mean, where do you want to live? With an umbrella in Frankfurt or with a beach in Granada or Malaga with a ski resort like here 20 minutes from your home? In the end, there is something happening in Spain. We have a lot of startups. We are not the Silicon Valley, that's true. This is unique in the world. But we see a vibrant economy, and we have some sectors where we are leaders in the world, infrastructure, renewables, and some others, no? So we would like, of course, to have more and more of every sector, companies in those sectors, no? But I mean, I think we are doing very well. The past 5 years, we have been growing above 3%, creating a lot of employment. We were very unlucky, no? We had the wrong government taking the wrong decisions at the worst time during the Lehman Brothers crisis, no? So that's why Spain was hit so hard. But I mean, since 2012, the policy has been the example in Europe, no? And well, we have the same problems that the French, Italians, Germans, UK people have, no? So if they are going to die, we will die with them, no? But I mean, we think Europe has, or is going to have also, a role in the world economy, no? Can you repeat to make?
How open has the U.S. been to receiving Spanish brands or welcoming Spanish brands?
Well, the first thing is that it's very difficult to get a visa for our people now, for most everybody, no, around the world, no, even though we are Europeans, no, and even though we have one problem in Spain, nobody wants to leave Spain. I mean, people are so happy in Spain, even though they don't make too much money, but I mean, the cost of living is not so high, so we are a very structured culture, like the Italians, no? I mean, we live very close to our grandfather, our mother, our parents, our friends, our brothers, sisters. So when we leave Spain, sometimes it's because we have an opportunity or because there is no opportunity in our sector in Spain, no? And usually, we have to say that Americans are very friendly. We really feel quite at home. If we don't feel much at home that we should, it's because we have this awful level of English, as you can see, and we struggle always, no? When we go abroad. We translate all the movies, no? This is an structural problem, no? That we shouldn't be doing that. Portugal, which is our neighbor, they don't translate the movies, and they have a much better level of English than Spain. That's that, just for that fact. And also because we don't move too much. I mean, we love to live in Spain. No? All my friends are always telling me, why are you abroad? I mean, why are you not here? No? Most like you Americans, you don't like also. But when we go to the northern part of Europe, I mean with frozen weather and not seeing the sun in years, I mean, we have 600,000 British people living in Spain, with houses in Spain, no? Like pretty much like Florida for the northern states in the United States. No? But going back to your question, we feel very fortunate because the Americans treat us really, really well. Even though, sorry, and this is something that I didn't mention in my presentation, but we also talk about renewable energy from Spain. We never say Spanish renewable energy because there is a confusion in the market between Latin America and Spain. And we love Latin America and our brothers from Latin America, but in the area of promoting our country, it doesn't help us to be in the same basket. You know? We want to be considered Europeans. You know? And I hope nobody gets mad about my remark.
Does the independence of Catalonia affect your country's image at all?
Sorry, because I'm very old. I don't hear very well.
Does the independence of Catalonia affect Spain's image?
Well, I knew this question was coming, eh? and I'm glad it's come, it came. Of course, because I think they won the image campaign. No? They presented this issue as the right to vote. No? And it's, this is not the issue, because imagine that we all here together, we decide to vote that we like this university, and we want this university to be our university. Eh? That we are going to be the owners of the university. We take a vote, and I think we're going to win, no? Because I love this university, I like it a lot. You think we will win the vote? But the thing is, you have the right to vote, or you don't have the right to vote. Go now to a company. In a company, the CEO, people don't like the CEO because the CEO is really the bad guy, no? Giving strong orders and being mad most of the time to make the company work. Or it can be, no, the case. It has not to be always, but. So you have, as employee, the right to vote to get rid of the CEO, no? This is something that you cannot vote. I mean, it's the board of directors, no? The stakeholders. No? So that's really what is happening in Spain. I mean, Catalonia has been part of Spain always. He has never been an independent country. The majority of the Catalonians wants to continue being part of Spain. It's true that they have a 48% of the population wanting to become independent, but still there is 52. And breaking a country is something that is really something very important. I mean, you cannot take a vote and not letting the people maybe vote in 10 years. And also, imagine that we let we give them the chance to vote. Will they give the chance also inside Catalonia to some territories have the right to vote, also to continue being part of Spain? No, they don't want that. They want If we vote that we go out of Spain, the whole Catalonia will be out of Spain. Why? I mean, if you want this vote for you, you have to give the right to some areas. For instance, Barcelona, I don't know, but if you read the newspapers, there is a movement now that is, the name is Tabarnia. Tabarnia comes from Tarragona and Barcelona, Tabarnia. And in there, 70% of the population wants to continue being part of Spain. And it's the capital, Barcelona. Eh? Barcelona is included in that area. So what is happening is that the rural area, the poor area of Catalonia, is overrepresented in the parliament, and then they have the majority in the regional parliament. But the regional parliament has the right to legislate in some issues, but not the right to break a country. So in the end, it's a difficult situation. It's costing Spain image, because we appear that we were hitting people that wanted to vote, but that's not the truth. The judges, we are a country like the US. We have the judicial power, the legislative power, and the government or executive power. So the judges were applying the constitutional mandates. The problem is that in front of the public opinion, the problem was presented in a different way. But believe me, it was an illegal poll, and only half of the population voted. The people that wanted to continue being part of Spain, they didn't go to vote, because they didn't think that it was legal, no, what was happening. And two or three months later, there were real elections. Against 52% want to continue being part of Spain, and 48. And just to finalize, they got this 58 in part because they have been investing for 30 years in the schools and trying to picture Spain as the people that are stealing money from Catalonia, which is not true, because as in America, which state pays more taxes, California or Alabama? I think California. Why? Because it's a richer state. So in the end, when you have a country, the people with more money pay more taxes, not the territories, the people. If the people that are paying more taxes now move to Marbella because they like the sun, Andalucía will be paying more taxes. I mean, I don't know if I have answered your question. Thanks for asking, because it's something that we are worried, of course. We don't really would like to see Catalonia departing. We love them. I have a brother living there, for instance, and it has been a part of Spain always. I mean, so imagine down now Utah wants to become an independent state. The Constitution of the United States doesn't recognize the right of Utah becoming an independent state. So, I mean, I don't know. I know that you're not thinking about that because you're very happy in the US. But in Europe, these things happen. And imagine what will happen to Europe if every region starts breaking apart. We will end with 200 new states. Well, maybe this is going to be the case, but I mean, at least as a Spaniard, I don't like the idea. Well, I don't see any.
Yeah.
I don't know if you can see me, but.
Yeah.
I don't see you. I
see a shadow. Kind of a follow-up question with that. Will they even have the? Because I know when Scotland was trying to become, you know, its own thing, away from, you know, the whole European Union, they didn't have like the infrastructure to even support the country. They didn't have like the means by which would.
Well, that's what we think they are lying to their people. The first thing they are saying to them is that we will continue being part of the European Union. But as you know, every country has a veto right. So what do you think Spain is going to do? Let Catalonia continue being part of the European Union? Of course not. If you leave, you leave. And for how long? Well, that's something to see. But I mean, Slovenia, for instance, took 10 years, no? To get back to the European Union, no? Or to get into the European Union. So it will be at least a generation. So they are using the public television, public newspapers, to confuse the people, because they are telling things to them that they are not true. They're going to be out. And this is going to be the GDP going down, at least for some years, a big crisis. In fact, they were telling all the time, no company is going to leave Catalonia. Once the October 1st vote took place, the most important companies left Catalonia the day after. Because how can a bank survive without a central European bank supporting and having all these, the business, most of the business in Europe and especially in Spain, no? So I think what is behind, and I'm sorry to tell you, is that most of the high-ranking officials are being prosecuted by the justice because they have been stealing, some of them, the parties they belong to them, they are being stealing and they are being prosecuted. So it has been, we call it huida hacia adelante. How do you call huida hacia adelante? To avoid the justice, they have just collided all of the main political figures to leave Spain. It was a personal, como se diría, right decision if you don't want to end on jail because they caught you stealing, no? And this is part of the reason what is happening in Spain. It's sad to tell, but I mean, it's part of the reason. Okay, thank you so much.